by Lauren Clark and Carrie Gilliam.
I remember wearing my purple jams and my jelly shoes and my matching jelly bracelets. Well, I really show my true colors.
Then we'll have Sarah Lander singing True Colors.
Too bad we can't do that anymore.
I'm sure somewhere we could.
Then Somewhere by Freshman Choir.
Well, whether or not that time comes again, someone once said, all your life experiences make you all the things you are.
And finally, All the Things You Are by Amy Garber.
Thank you. be discouraged, oh, I realize it's hard to take courage in a world full of people. You can lose sight of it all, the darkness so inside me makes you feel so small. But I see your true colors shining through. I see your true colors, and that's why I love you. So don't be afraid to let it show your true colors, beautiful like a rainbow. Show me a smile and don't be unhappy, can't remember when I last saw you laughing. If this world makes you crazy and you take it all you can, then you call me because you know I'll be there. And I see your true colors shining through. I see your true colors, and that's why I love you. So don't be afraid to let it show your true colors, true. Makes you crazy, you take it all you can, but you call me because you know I'll be there. And I see your true colors shining through. I see your true colors, and that's why I love you. So don't be afraid to let it show your true colors, true colors, true colors of shining. I see your true colors, and that's why I love you. So don't be afraid to let it show your true colors, beautiful like a rainbow.
Thank you.
call me back last night.
All right, well, I think you ought to take a little advice from a men's chorus. They're going to sing, I Wish to Be Single.
Okay. Megan, all guys aren't that bad. I think you should listen to the song that Jen Marsick, Deborah Heiss, and Kate Opperman are singing. They're singing All for Love. Maybe you guys can get back together.
Yeah, and Lori, Women's Crawl is singing The Man I Love. And let me tell you about him. He's so great.
No, okay, you don't have to tell us all about him. You know, I know, we ought to listen to Mark Donmore for once. He's singing something about the giants in the sky, and, well, you know, men just think they're that. Maybe.
Just Saw me live and more not know. How can
Okay, and next we have Symphonic Choir singing Trickle Trickle. Then Kelly Eisman, Ruthie Brown, and Katie Queen will sing The Rose.
Then Katie Gerber will sing I Dream of a Dream.
And then Lori's gonna sing And I'm Telling You I'm Not Going.
And then Freshman Choir will sing from the musical Newsies, Seize the Day.
And then Treble Tones will sing a 50s doo-wop medley.
Thank you. Bye. Do-ba-do, do-ba-do, do-ba-do.
Mercy brings time.
like everyone to sing.
And Wait.
The first one.
Booking.
The
bank.
I'm so inspired by you. That hasn't happened for the long.
Women's Chorale singing Annie Laurie.
And after that, we have In the Evening by the Moonlight by Men's Chorus.
We have Alex Cornhill singing Send in the Clowns.
Symphonic Choir will sing Being Green. So that's all.
That's all.
Okay, now you may think that looked really stupid, but the last thing I told everyone at dress rehearsal was make sure that when you pick up a mic, you put it back in the same place you found it. Brian Burley is a very, very, very close friend of mine. In fact, when we were 4 years old, we thought that we were cousins, and then when we were 12 year olds, our parents told us that we actually weren't, so we cried, and we've been very, very close. I think his mother and my mother met each other when they were little kids at a church choir camp or something, but Brian has been gracious the past several years to run sound for us in musical and showtime, and believe me, it is a very difficult job to do, especially when you have absolutely no clue as to who's on what mic. So I want to give him a big round of applause because he makes a good impression. I'd also like to thank all the technical people that have helped, and some of them aren't mentioned in the program. And Steve, if I can think of your last name, I'm going to introduce you. Swanson. I apologize. Steve Swanson's on Follow Spot, which will probably go off about right now because I forgot his name. So thank you, Steve. We appreciate it. Well, this has been an interesting year and also a very successful year. And I always dread this time, and I'm telling myself that I will not get all choked up and teary-eyed. Of course, if I don't, then I'm going to get yelled at because of what you did last year. But I'm going to try to do this, which means I probably won't turn around and face him because it works better that way. But this has been an extremely, extremely successful year with all the groups, in particular Symphonic, who for the fourth year, I believe, in a row, received superior ratings in Class AA at district and state contests, so they deserve a good one. And now comes the tough part, saying goodbye to some extremely, extremely talented people. I'm going to miss them very, very much. I know a lot of the underclassmen are going to miss them as well. And I know they're going to go on to bigger and certainly much greater and better things. And we hope you take a little piece of Thomas Worthington with you. So, starting with Concert Choir. We're doing okay time-wise. Starting with Concert Choir, I'm going to announce the seniors, and they're going to come out here and stand in front of our stuffed animals or somewhere in that vicinity. And then we have another very, very, very special treat for you. Starting with Concert Choir, Marky Bourgeois. Amy Badinsky. Michelle Garachet. Allison Hoffman. Krista Robbins. From Women's Chorale, April Donaldson. Chrissy Mitchell. Michelle Molan. Actually, Steve, you can take the spot off for just a second. I'll have you put it on the set. John, you can throw some more lights on here so that we can see all these kind of people. From Symphonic Choir, Amy Baumgartner, the Birthday Girl. Kristen Karras, who was also in Women's Chorale, she did double duties this year. Patty Cassidy. Lauren Clark. Lori Cook. Brian Cooper. Adam Lasego. Jen Marsick. Meredith Melman. Matt Schoenbarger. Mark Schreiber. And CJ Swain. And Shelby Nelson. The class of 1994. Just informed me there's 5 more days. And a big choir final. I don't want to go on and on and on about these young people, but I'm going to miss them greatly, and hopefully they will continue tradition and come back and visit me, okay? Anytime. Please make sure that I get your addresses and phone numbers, because if I don't, then I don't get to call you and write to you. Thank you for a wonderful, wonderful year, and for many of you, many wonderful years and some great experiences. Now comes the treat. Before we do the treat, I also want to tell you that we have a brand new tape that we made. It just came out yesterday. Came out. It sounds important, like it's in record stores or something, which it isn't. But, it is this year's Women's Chorale Symphonic Choir. Singing about 45, 50 minutes of beautiful music that we've done this year. And if you would like, they are going to be for sale also afterwards, and they're going to cost $7 each. And we would love to have you purchase one so you can hear the kind of talent that's represented.
We're going to do something now. Every year it's tradition for us to get Mr. Carson something so that we can really make him ball up here on stage and embarrass him. And one of the things he got him was some flowers. And I can say personally, I've had Mr. Carson as a teacher for 5 years, since way back when in middle school. And he's grown up a little since then, you know. First, we'd like to give him a present from all of our choirs. And that one. And there's a little something that goes along with this, but we'll wait till he opens it. I know. Isn't it pretty paper? No. It's a big boy. That's not just for you, you have to share. Okay.
Oh, do we need this?
This is because Mr. Parsons a while ago had said it's been a long time since he's seen a movie. So we got him 2 passes for a movie and dinner for him and his wife. And along with that, we would like to offer ourselves to babysit, free of charge, for Rebecca. From Symphonic Choir for Mr. Parsons to share. And it's again in the green paper.
I'm really glad it's autographed because one of these days, several of these names are going to be worth some big bucks. And I will have the luxury of being one of the only ones to have early autographs. But thank you very much. On behalf of my wife and my babysat daughter, we will really enjoy the movie. We generally wait until summer and then rent everything that's been out over the past year before school starts again. So we'll enjoy this very much. I'm going to lay some things down for a second because we have a little surprise. It is it's an annual tradition also that you be addressed, seniors, by the top dog, the head honcho, the man. Of course, I'm speaking of Mr. Norther. And I want to tell you a very interesting story, and I'll make it a very quick version. A music teacher many years ago saw this young man named Billy, and well, he probably was never that little, but, and said, and well, he's a football player, and said, why don't you be in choir? And so he started singing, and the choir director, I think as the story goes, if I don't mix this up, the choir director said, listen, that's fine. Here's what I want you to do. When we get to the end of the song, just go, oh, yeah. And I'm pretty sure I have the story correct. Of course, that was his freshman year in high school. That was the only year he was in choir. But it's been so long since he sung, and singing is just like, you know, riding a bicycle when you get back on and you just pump those pedals. We would like to, this is the first time this will ever be done, and probably the last, because I will be employed somewhere else next year. We would like to have Mr. Norther come up and join us in a song, and we want him to put the tag at the end. So, Mr. Norther, if you would, please. We'll put him on red, Brian.
Symphonic Choir a round of applause for that great piece. Now, a few of my friends from the 50s brought a message to the seniors. First of all, Bill Haley and the Comets have to say to you, see you later, alligator. Ricky Nelson would be singing to you tonight if he was here, I'm a traveling man. And you seniors will be traveling, but as Mr. Parsons said, we want you to come back. So like Bobby V said, like a rubber ball, I'll come bouncing back to you.
No.
There can be exceptions, Brian. By the way, I thought it would have been nice, Mr. Parsons, if we'd have lined them up, boy, girl, boy, girl. No, I guess that wouldn't have worked, but, no, okay. Along the way, also, a couple other groups came along. One of them was Bobby Darin. He was singing Splish Splash, I'll Be Taking a Bath on about a Saturday night. That's just a hint about personal hygiene the rest of your life along the way. And finally, the last group that's coming along is Peter, Paul, and Mary, and they are singing This Land Is Your Land, This Land Is My Land. Now, the message in that is, and this is a serious message, is that our country today, in the shape that it's in many ways, needs the type of seniors that we have on the stage tonight to go out, be leaders, and help lead our country in the right direction. And this class, the class of 94, has the ability to do that. So let's give them a final tribute.
Yeah.
put sand in the clouds. Don't bother, they're here. He is indeed rich, he is indeed queen. Losing my time, being misled.
time, 1994, music throughout our lives. We hope you have a wonderful evening from here on out. We're going to close the show with a song called Friends, and that's